Yo, guys, it's real. It's finally here. Welcome back, one and all, to a brand spanking new series of... Wait a second. Where's my skin? Where's my chest? Where are those big old biceps? Yeah, we start out with a set of tech gear. if you're wondering how we got here, hey, I uploaded a video a couple days ago that you should go ahead and watch. It'll get you up to scratch, and I guess it'll answer those few little questions. But yes, we've made it. We're finally here in the flesh and ready to tackle a brand new world of Ark. I'm actually really excited about this one here. More so than I think I was for Genesis Part 1. I think just looking around this area as a whole, like already just that alone, this is my type of map. This is my type of biome. It's bright. It's well lit. We have beaches. We're not stuck in a swamp. We're not stuck in a volcano. We're not in an icy like blizzard. No. This is my style of Ark. This is how I love it. But guys, it's going to be a fun one. I'm really, really excited to check out all the new creatures and work our way through this. From what I've seen in the trailer, this DLC looks like it's going to be something special. I've obviously checked a few things out already. If you've been following the channel, we've dropped a few videos of the ending of the game, but we haven't played through any of the process to actually get there. So we're going to be going through it all firsthand together. It's going to be exciting. If you want to help me kick this series off with a bang, if you're excited or you just feel like hitting a button, then please go ahead, punch that thumbs up, make it ring. Those thumbs ups. We do have a couple mods currently in this pack currently. Just little ones like, you know, your spyglass and I think we got S plus in here as well. Just those tiny little things that are just going to make our day and life just a tiny little bit better. But damn, is it weird just starting out with tech? This could be the first time I think we've ever actually survived like an episode one of a series. I mean, I'm in a suit of tech gear. We've got levels up our sleeve already. 5 of them, as a matter of fact. Let me just go and give myself some health. Let me go and give myself some melee damage because I assume we're going to be using a bit of that. But yeah, this is bizarre. This is weird. This is crazy. This is just goodness. I love it. Yeah, I think we're going to survive. we're actually going to achieve greatness and not die in an episode 1. Or maybe I'm just getting a little bit ahead of myself. But yeah, I want to check out this map, man. It looks beautiful. It's obviously like oozing vibes of like Halo. Oh man, like just seeing the big old ring. I wish you could kind of see it a little bit better through the surface. Also, is there like, oh, I don't have a spyglass. I swear I see like numbers up there on that hexagon that's kind of overseeing our little thingamabobby here. Also, yeah, this isn't an arc. I guess we're actually on a spaceship hurtling through space. So completely different scenario for this one here. Oh, and by the way, I should probably go ahead and like, hey, look, I completely forgot about the cutscene. You want to go and watch the opening cutscene for Genesis? Look, here you go. Here you go. Give it a view. Give it a watch.
Really got you good. No worries, just hang in there for a second. There! Good news. Your armor kept you mostly in one piece. So, quick update. This isn't a simulation. We're really on a ginormous spaceship. And the ship's been taken over by...
Now what are you two little gnats up to? This is to be mine. The first of me.
Okay, time to get away from all these tentacles and prying eyes. This might feel a bit weird.
Yeah, so I guess that's how we ended up here. So I guess we should get the ball rolling, shouldn't we, HLNA? Also, do you have like... Yeah, I guess we can
Welcome
still exchange hexagons through
exchange.
You. And I assume we get these just through missions. I don't know if there's other means of collecting them. Oh, no, you can... I completely forgot. I think you can sell resources as well, can't you? Or can you just buy them? Man, I really got to refresh my knowledge on the whole, like, Genesis scenarios. But let's get this show underway. Let's get started. Hey, I just realized I can actually drop some of these bombs, baby. Yeah. Oh, wait, no. Normal punches are weak. These ones here, on the other hand, yeah, I'm so not dying today. This is beautiful. This is the type of, like, survival I need. I need to spawn with, like, endgame gear. I feel like it's my only, like, chance. But anyways, we got ourselves some resources. No, I don't have stone yet. Alright, let me go for a little bit of a... Hey, there we go. I wasn't sure if you'd be able to pick these ones here up or if they had to be harvested, but there we go. But yeah, throughout this series, I think we're going to like throw in maybe, I don't know, we'll gauge how things are going. We might add a few mods along the way just to like give us a tiny little bit of an extra... I don't know. That's the thing. It's going to be a completely new experience that we're kind of like unprepared for. So it's going to be a lot of learning, a lot of adjusting, a lot of, I don't know, new experiences, which I'm really, really excited about. It should be fun. And hey, if you want to keep up to date with uploads over the course of this series, then make sure you also go ahead and subscribe to the channel for top tier mediocre content. I don't know how something could be top tier and mediocre at the same time, but look, I can't guarantee the top tier content part, but the mediocre part, definitely plenty of mediocreness. Plenty of, look, probably a lot of failing. Let's be real with ourselves here. But we're here to get set up today. If we can get ourselves established with a base, with some tools, with some survivingness. If we can survive, that'd be like enough for me. Also, it looks like, I was going to say you can't use your jetpack while crafting. Yeah. Fancy that, eh? Fancy that. Also, this is so good. You can literally just travel anywhere you like. Oh my gosh, I love it. Wait, can I do my little, like, can you do your little boost along the ground thing? I assume you can. Damn, man, there's so many, like, potential base locations. Man, we got tech dinosaurs down here too. This is a lot to soak in, but I want to find some of these new dinosaurs. I don't even know if there's any point finding them, like, this early in the series, but... obviously, I'm not ready to go tame in any of them, but... Oh, my gosh. I'm excited. Let's just keep the ball rolling, though, and work our way through this. We're obviously going to need... Did I end up killing that parrot? Oh, now I'm heavy. Oh, no. Oh, no. What's weighing me down? I need some levels into weight, I guess. There we go. That'll sort that out. All right. Let's get some armor going. Get some armor of that. We need to give ourselves every opportunity we can to survive, of course. Oh, and in case you were wondering and you haven't like looked too far into content and stuff, we still got the missions. There's still missions in the game, except they're very, very different to the way they played out in Genesis. Obviously, they like consumed most of the map in Genesis. This time around, I think they're all kind of located from, or like accessible from one location. And you, for some of them, they're actually in the real world. In others, you actually need to enter the simulation. You're going back into the Genesis simulation. I guess Rockwell still kind of controls that. So that's a thing. But yeah, we're gonna do some stuff. We're going to get into this thing. I got to find some hide and stuff, though, I think. So we can get, like, set up with, obviously, some proper armor and a bed and whatnot. But let's have a little bit of a look around and see what we can find. I love that we can just travel anywhere we like. It's bizarre. It's bizarre just spawning in and being able to just roam. Not only that, we don't need element to power this suit. I think that's like the most bizarre part about the whole thing. It's kind of weird. It's like we got some super unelemented tech in. Hey, I see you there, buddy. I see you there. The first of, I guess, new creatures. This guy. I can't remember what these guys are called, but they're a thing, and they look freaking awesome. They look Star Wars inspired. Oh, gosh. I want one. Also, dodos. Nice. Okay, I can get some nice hide and some meat, which is cool. I can't remember what these things are called. I think I heard a bird of some sort. All right. Sorry, little dodos. But I kind of like... Yeah. I need some stuff from yous. Give me some meat so I can actually survive. I'll get myself a little bit of... oh, my gosh. I love how we... You don't even need weapons. You don't even need weapons anymore. I mean, you kind of, like, do, I suppose. But, like, I don't know. Like, for real, you're dealing, like, 250 damage straight off the bat. Why did I even bother learning a spear? I don't need a spear. We've got everything that we need to deal more damage than a spear will probably do. Right? This is bizarre. This is such a weird feeling. Anyways, let's get this armor on. Actually, no. Why am I crafting armor? Oh, my gosh. It just occurred to me. I've got armor. Mjolnir, you haven't stopped talking about the darn armor since you spawned in this world. Why? Look, okay. I'm overwhelmed, okay? My senses are all over the place right now. There's a lot going on. So I feel like I can be given, like, a pass to a little bit of my naivety, my stupidity. I want to tame this thing here, though. Or do we want to kill it? I don't know. Like, We don't know enough about these new creatures yet. I'm kind of going in quite blind with these guys. I love the design on him. He's obviously passive. Oh, here we go. Used mutagen in the last slot to initiate hacking. Requires 23 mutagen? Oh, wait. And 0 of 36 missions. Wait, what? Wait, sorry? You gotta complete the missions to do it? Wait, is that actual? To get a Strider? All right, I'm gonna look into that. That seems hectic. That's like, that means they're like end game, like territory. I kind of want to punch one just to see if they like drop some elements or something, to be honest. But all right, let me get some food first up. I think I might. I gotta know. We gotta know. All right, food and thirst are now sorted, which is nice. Look, just to see, just for testing purposes, scientific reasons. We're gonna make big mistakes. All right, doesn't seem too aggressive. I don't think he's an aggressive beast. I think he's willing to take my beatings. All right, now I don't know how much health these things have got. I love the animations on them. Wow. Yo, okay. All right, careful. Just nearly wiped us out with a single hit. Well, at least 50% of the way. All right, maybe if we just punch him in the butt. Maybe that's the strat. Thing is, I was gonna say he's not bleeding. It's a mech. Of course he's not bleeding, bro. What do you expect from a mech? He just seems to just be okay, cool. Well, like, he doesn't have any ranged attacks, so that's quite nice. I'm just trying to punch him in the butt. One last. Yeah, no, he's got a bit of health. He's got a chunk of health. I also didn't have a look at what sort of level he is. I think I've set the max level of this. Okay, now we're cool. I was just testing scientific purposes. Come on, you should appreciate science. You're literally made by science. You're a mech. But yeah, as I was saying, I think the max level for this world is 300. I think that's how I've set it. So we're going a little bit more on the upper end of the level system. I think by default, you're looking at about 150. So we've gone a little bit of above and beyond just to make things a little bit more interesting. But let's have a look. What can we actually get crafting right now? We can get some spy glasses if I could find some crystal. A canoe! That's one of the new items! Actually, we should have a look at the new items, shouldn't we? Wait, can I? Oh, there we go. So, canoe is one of the first new items, of course. Then one of the saddles. Oh, that's the Maywing! Oh, if I can go and find a Maywing, that'd be pretty darn sick, to be honest. I don't know where they spawn, though. I assume they spawn around here. Also just realized we're not going to be taking fall damage, are we? All right, let me just... Yeah, he's forgiven us. It's all good. All right, pick up our campfire and let's keep moving. So I believe... Wait, hold on. What have I just seen over here? Hold on. Is that a Maywing? I don't think Maywing would be in the water. What am I looking at? Oh, it's a Triceratops. Yeah. Okay, Miola. You're starting to show your lack of arc knowledge here, buddy. All right. Okay, let's keep this thing moving, though. I want to see if we can find one of these Maywings. I don't actually know how they're tamed up. So Maywings are like the giant, they're kind of like Australian beasts, actually. They're a mix of like a platypus and like a, I think we call them like a, these guys right here, we found them. Nice. Yeah, so as you can see, they have like a duck bill or a platypus bill. I guess they look very platypusy. If you don't know what a platypus is, it's one of these things, native to Australia. I don't think I've actually ever seen one in person. I'm trying to look at the front of this thing, but he's just burrowing into the rock. There we go. Have a look at the thing. And I guess they're kind of like a combo of that and a like a sugar glider. We got a lot of weird creatures in Australia, but they can like glide. They're really, really cool. And I assume they're marsupials in that they've got like a little pouch or something. But basically, these guys here, they want to look after your babies. I just don't know how we're gonna knock one out. I actually don't know. Now, the more I think about it, they're not passive tames. They're clearly not passive tames because it's not giving me an option to passive tame them, which means we are going to need, well, other means. Either we're going to have to level up a few times, and I'm clicking all sorts of buttons that I'm not really intending to, but we're either going to need the net so we can catch them and do something like that, or maybe you just got to use tranks. Obviously, we don't have either of those things because we got to get settled, but all right, I don't know what I planned to gain from finding one of these, to be honest. We found them and quickly realized that we are not ready to tame them up. So let's build a little house. I think that's going to be our best bet to get started here. Let's find ourselves a nice little, I don't know. I guess nothing needs to be permanent. We could find ourselves a nice little island, but then I kind of want to, I guess we don't even have to be like accessible to much, but you know what? This beach over here looks pretty sweet. Really, we're not too far from everything. We can, oh, here we go. This is what I was talking about just a second ago. But really, if we need to like travel anywhere, we can just fly across the sky. We don't even need a team flyers for that. This here though is what I was talking about earlier. This is one of the few pads around the map that are going to allow you to access the missions, or at least begin the missions. They're all started from here. There's a bunch of them. Wait, this looks like a journal entry. Wait, what did you find? Wait, what was she looking at? Hold on, there. Yo, we've got survivor notes on this map. I actually did not realize that. Oh, that's cool. Dude, all right. Yo, wait, is that? Oh no, for a second there, I thought that was Santiago, AKA Vin Diesel, but no. All right, let's have a little look. Log 13, near dark, the girl was excited to show me something. She'd pried open one of her hidden doors and pressed her magic device against the machinery inside. I didn't follow what she tried to explain to me next. Nita said I was wired to connect to a sort of game she'd made from my time in the Shadowlands she called Genesis. Then she did something, and all at once, I was on another world in a new body. There's like a little thing here as well. Image file, angel. She meant to be like modeled after an angel. Anyways, there were no wheels overheard, only a setting sun scattered with clouds. I struggled to understand, had I ever truly been in Nita's sky garden? I called to her, but instead heard the voice of the angel I'd met in purgatory. The angel told me something important. Then I was yanked back into reality. If this was actually reality. I'm so bad at reading, aren't I? Nita grinned at me and asked what I thought, and I got sick all over the canyon floor. That's a pretty, I like these explorer notes. They look sick, by the way. I would say that would have been easier. Oh, okay, here we go. So this was written by Gabriel, and this is his 13th log. I'm not too sure who Gabriel is, but maybe we'll find out over the course of the series. Anyways, cool. Do we try a mission? Or do we, let's just set up shop, okay? Oh, our first actual aggressive dinosaur. Get absolutely dunked on, buddy. That's what you get, little Dilo. That's what you get. Come at me like that. What did you expect to happen? But anyways, this is kind of the area I think I was looking to set up in. This is a sweet little spot. We can set up a nice little house here. We can live off the land a little bit. We're going to need some resources. We're obviously going to have to learn some engrams as well. Where's my thatch stuff? Where's my thatch? Yeah. Obviously, we're going to be starting out with... We got the S-Plus mod installed. May as well just use it. We got a storage box. Why not? We got some walls. Yes. Ceilings? No, we don't put ceilings on our base. Nah, I think we probably should. Hey, little guys. You guys are going to be a pain in my butt, aren't you? So, I apologize, but... Not in the mood for it right this second. I got a base to build. And we were... we're going to get into this thing. So, we're going to need some wood. Oh, great. Why have I chosen to build a base around, well, the first of the carnivorous dinosaurs that we've actually encountered? Look, if I don't fight this Dilo, he's gonna fight me. Also, I'm kind of thinking maybe we do need a spear because the recharge time... Aw, who killed the little Lystro? He didn't deserve that. Also, what is that over there? Oh, it's another Strider. Oh, we got Striders out here too. Okay, cool. All right, cool. Well, let me get some wood. Let me get some wood so we can actually get this base up and running. Now I'm really heavy. Fantastic. But hopefully we've got enough resources that I can actually craft up a few foundations. Three of them. That's not a lot of foundations, but I guess it'll have to do. We've also already got 15 levels, and I guess that's because we've just gone and killed a bunch of dinosaurs with, obviously, the Explorer Note experience buff, which is doing its thing. Yeah, that's fair enough. Well, let's get some extra melee damage because we clearly don't have enough of that already, do we? And I guess now we've unlocked wood stuff, so I should just craft up some wood stuff instead, shouldn't we? All right, wood foundations. Let me just unlock it just to start us out, I suppose. What do I need to get some more of those? Probably, oh, thatch. We need thatch. And I'm heavy. And I can't move. Oh, no. Can I punch? Are we gonna travel around using punches? I think that's literally what we're gonna have to do. Oh, we can cut down trees like that? Yeah, that's so good. All right, nice, that's perfect. Yay, we got the thatch that we need. I guess that's one way to do things. What can I say? Dude, this is sweet. All right, we're gonna need fiber. Can I pick any? Yeah, we can kind of pick stuff. I like this. I like this a lot. So we're just gonna like punch our way around. Hey, look. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes, all right? All we're doing is weighing ourselves down so much more than we have to, but oh my gosh, that is a lot of, that's a lot of thatch. Okay, cool. Well, two more foundations? Oh, I need more wood now. All right, we're gonna try not to punch the tree down. And I just, damn it, dang. Okay, all right, this method of travel, oh wait, no, I can't. This method of travel isn't one that I'd advise. It really isn't effective. I don't recommend it. It's really not working out very well for me. I think I'm going to have to drop some of these resources as a matter of fact. But where was it that I was going to build this base? Yeah, I got to drop some of this stuff. Wait, we got a little... I got my little box that I need wood for. Of course I do. I just need a land next to it. I guess that'll do. That'll do. All right. Let me drop some of my very, very heavy... Oh my gosh, so much thatch. And of course I placed it just out of my own reach. even when you get everything handed to you, you still struggle, mate. You still struggle. All right, just, there we go. That's the way. All right. This is my thatch box. All it gets is thatch. That's all we needed for. And I'm still heavy. All right, well, it looks like I'm putting, why have I got 13 more levels? So my experience rates, I thought were pretty, oh my gosh. We are like over leveling so darn fast. Look, I think I got to fix that up. We're leveling way too quickly, man. Way too fast. Oh, great. Okay, fantastic. No, I can't even move. Leave me alone, you stupid Dilo. Go away. Okay, now my fists aren't even working. Fist attack. Okay, my fists actually aren't working. Oh, I can move. Slowly but surely. Wait, can I use mine? Gee. No, I can't. All right, fine. We're going to have to just... Why aren't these fists working? All right, please. Just let me run away. What led us to this moment? I decided to relog and reset our XP. Okay, this is absurdity. Oh, I can fly. Of course I can fly. Okay. Take that, stinking Dilo. Take that. So I basically relogged and adjusted our XP rate because our XP rate is just absolutely insane. So we should be a little bit more balanced now, but I'll kind of keep an eye on it and adjust it accordingly. We got 10 levels up our sleeve though. Luckily we put these past 10 levels into health. Otherwise, there is no chance I would have survived that little Dilo encounter just then. But anyways, melee damage. Let's get some movement speed. Why not? Hey, no, he literally traveled all the way over here. All right. Well, this time around, I'm not going to go easy. This time, no more Mr. Okay. I swear my fists aren't working. All right, come on. Hold on. There was an arc update between... Oh, I'm not even damaging this thing. Okay, no. All right, I'm out of here. Stuff this for a joke. I don't know what is going on, but little Dilo over here be invincible to my fists. I feel like... this Dilo won't bugger off either. He's still Jason. Look, let me just... Yeah, my fists aren't working anymore. What is going on? Was that just not... It's not working. Either I've lost the plot, or this... I'm not even... Wait. There we go. Is it because I'm on the ground? That also makes absolutely no sense. It is preposterous. All right, now that's it. No. I'm not playing with little Dilo boy anymore. I'm done with him. That's it. So I guess we're going to have to need some weapons after all. I don't know if something got patched, because like I said, there was an update between the first half of this video and now. So that could explain what just went down. But I have no clue whatsoever. What I do have a clue about is that I am going to build a nice old house right here on the beach. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to be serene. It's probably going to get attacked by that Dilo that for whatever reason has like... He's like little Terminator Dilo. He just won't give me a break. Also... Oh, I was going to say... Wait, why can't I pick this bush? All right, you get out of the way, old fan. I can't get rid of this bush. Oh, there we go. Okay, man, that bush was like as stubborn as that Dilo was. Don't ask me what his problem is there. That was a very, very weird, a very weird scenario. Anyways, we got a little shelter now, so that's quite nice. I don't know what I'm gonna do with these thatch ones. I was thinking maybe I just put like a little, a little something out the front here. I guess I could go and mix things up a bit, but we definitely got to get some walls going. I haven't even learnt wooden walls though, apparently. So let's quickly go and grab some adoos. All right, now I guess we're probably gonna need some wood. Yes, yes, definitely gonna need some wood, except I don't wanna drop my beautiful little treat. Oh, I forgot about this. Oh, you've got my wood. All 30 pieces of it. Well, let's go and make ourselves ridiculously heavy again, shall we? And we're gonna get some walls. 4 of them to be exact. Oh, and cannot forget, cannot forget. I need a bed. I like urgently need a bed. So let's get one of those too. That way, when we do eventually die, actually, is dying even a problem anymore? Now that I think about it, I'm probably gonna respawn with a tech suit of armor. So like, is that really a bad thing? I still can't believe I crafted up like a set of cloth armor. I feel like a royal dum-dum for that one there. That's a silly move on my part. What are you gonna do? All right, 3 more walls because why not? Let's waddle our way back to base because that's how we move around as a very, very slow person. And I am going to, I guess, throw down some wooden walls because why not? Yeah, I don't know what I was going for here. That was a very weird placement of walls, but it's fine. It's enough to give me this beautiful little sleeping spot right here. Bada bing, bada boom. It's enough to go and I guess I could just pick this up or I could just craft another one. No, I cannot because wood. How do I need wood. I need wood. I need wood, I guess. Wood is really holding me back right now. But then I get heavy again, and then I can't do nothing. All right, look, storage box, check. Man, the more I think about it, this Genesis tech suit, what is this actually called, by the way? This is called Federation Exo... Okay, so it's called Exo. It's not tech. It's Federation Exosuit. And that's because I think the Genesis... Well, I'm pretty sure the spaceship in lore is based around... the opposition to the people who created the Ark or something. I think it's 2 different, like, warring factions of Earth type of thing. Basically, one of them decided to try and save the Earth using Arks, while the other one went with the Genesis simulation slash this spaceship. I don't know what this spaceship is called, but yeah, that was, I guess, their solution. Both of which got ruined by Rockwell, so I guess it kind of didn't really matter in the end anyways. But here we go. At least we've got some storage. I got to get myself a preserving bin set up as well, but at least now I can just dump a ton of this very, very heavy stuff that I don't need to be carrying around. I can actually drop this stuff because I do not need cloth armor. But what I was looking at is this armor set only has 20 armor. So either maybe you can get some upgraded sets of it. I'm not too sure. Or, I guess you're still going to need different sets of armor. Because I'm pretty sure that's the equivalent of what? Like, hide? I'm pretty sure it's hide. Yeah, hide is 20 armor. So this armor gives you absolutely no protection. It's literally just like wearing like an undersuit. That's it. It looks tough. It looks cool. It looks actually really, really nice. But it's not that armorful. It's kind of like riot gear. If the riot gear, the Kevlar, whatever riot gear is made of like, cloth or like it's like wool. I don't know, you can just poke something straight through it. But anyways, oh, that's right, I want to get myself a mortar and pestle. If I can get that, I don't even have one crafted. What do you call it? I don't have one of these yet. I haven't learnt the engram just yet. But I want to get a mortar and pestle, some spark powder. That would be kind of sick to craft up as well. But most importantly, not mortar and pestle, I need myself some narcotics. Yes, indeed we do. We also need a bow and a crossbow. Oh my gosh, we can already get a smithy. And then we're gonna need, did I already do arrows? No, I didn't do arrows yet. We need some train carriers and stuff as well. Fantastic, easy peasy. So what am I, actually while I'm at it, why don't I just quickly learn a smithy or an S plus smithy, I guess, for that matter, and a forge as well. Yeah, we're getting there. That's the main thing here. So if I were to want, of course I would need some wood if I were to want a bow. But what I'm thinking is we may, I don't know, maybe I can get a little bow and some arrows set up, or at least get them going so that tomorrow we can actually head out on an adventure to tame some stuff up. I think that's what, that's kind of like the goal at the moment. We got to get set up so we can actually go and get some dinosaurs. So we actually go and tame some stuff up. And the more I think about it, I think a lot of the stuff I said earlier, kind of not true. I basically said, because we got this set of armor, flyers are irrelevant. Wrong. Because, like I said, this armor is weak. We're going to need some stronger stuff soon. And as we upgrade to stronger armor, we're obviously going to lose the ability to fly in the process. So it's a bit of a trade-off with the armor. I guess there's a few different ways that you can run at this DLC. You can just kind of chill and be a bit of a pincushion, like single hit, and you're pretty much dead. Once I guess you start dealing with stronger dinosaurs, or I guess you ditch the exosuit as soon as possible and you get some stronger armor, and then you can survive a little bit nicer. What do you guys think? Let me know down below in the comments what your thoughts are on that whole situation, or at least what your strategy would be in that sort of circumstance. I do need some crystal too, because I want to get a spyglass set up soon. And then, yeah, like I was saying, we're going to need some narcotics. Can I get a mortar and pestle, like, right this second? Because that would be kind of sweet if we could. Yes. Yes, we can. Okie dokie. Well, I'm just going to place it next to my bed. No, why would I place it next to my bed? I still wish you could place stuff like... I wish you could place these on stuff other than just the table. I feel like we need more tables, basically. Have I learned narcotics? I did learn narcotics. Okay. Consumables, drugs. Let's go and chuck those in there. I've already got the narco berries already, I'm pretty sure. And then I guess we could just split stack. Split it all. Oh, split you as well. How long is this stuff going to take to... 7 minutes to spoil? I just realized as well, because we've gained all of these levels, we've probably unlocked a bunch of stuff like the Maywing saddle. We're obviously going to need some metal though. We got the loadout mannequin. I want to check that out. That's one of the new... Oh, obviously one of the new items. These are all of the new items. Ammo box deploys device to supply ammunition to nearby turrets. This is cool, but I kind of want to have a play with it and see what it can do. I've never really used the turrets a whole lot. The jar of pitch. I actually don't know what this does. Lights the target on fire and can also light oil slicks. Can be fired from a ballista turret or catapult. That's similar. So I think Scorched Earth had something to the tune of that. May as well learn it. But it sounds like it is a turret item. But I guess we may as well look into grabbing some metal. I'm assuming this rock here gonna help us out. These little river rocks are great for early game metal, so we may as well just give them a little bit of a twist and get some nice and easy metal out of those. Then we can at least get set up with a forge as quick as possible. Actually, no. You don't actually need metal for a forge, do you? You just need other stuff. Yeah, the other stuff. You need the other stuff. Not enough. Yes, I know my inventory is rather full, isn't it? Probably should have put some extra... Oh my gosh, because I've got 250... I've got like... Okay, we have way too much... Why have I got all this wood on me? 1 second. Just gonna waltz my way all the way back to base so we can drop this stuff here off. If I were to want a forge though, what would I need? Stone and fiber. That's it. A little bit of stone, a little bit of fiber. I'm gonna get that real quick. I'm gonna get that right now. A little bit of stone, like I said. And then let's just dart our way across here really, really quickly. I love it. 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 And I think that's good for fire. But man, we are just smashing this. We are absolutely killing it. Where's my forge? No, smithy. Forge. What are we getting? We're getting a forge. Let's get the forge. Check. A mundo. I'm going to go place it in my new beautiful base, which is going to be absolutely amazing once this thing is fully completed. I've already built more of a base this season than I did in our entire previous, like, modded survival. So, that's impressive, I think. I think we've already exceeded expectations. And then I need some fuel, so I guess I'll just grab some wood from our chest. Light this baby up on fire and let's set it to go. I think we've got a little bit of metal in here still, too. I'm gonna burn mostly wood for this, I think. At least for now, just so we can get some, charcoal. But yeah, once we have that going, we can pretty much get our smithy set up now-ish. No, I need hide and I need stone. Ooh, okay. Okay. A little bit of stone. Hey, buddy. Is this gonna work? I don't think my fists are working anymore. Why not? Why can't I launch into stuff? All right, tell me that wasn't something that just rolled out in an update. Because before I reset, I could do that. Now, all of a sudden, I can't. And now, all of a sudden, I can't actually do damage to anything. And it's making me really, really sad. I'm going to need a spear. I need a spear is what I'm going to need. Of course, I need wood. How is it that wood is the one resource we have kind of so much of right now? It keeps weighing us down. Yet, on top of that, I keep needing it. Also, I got arrows. What am I doing? I don't even... Oh, man. It's going to take a few of these to take this guy down, though, isn't it? All right. I think my spear is going to be the way to go here. There you're at. All right, cool. Or maybe if I could just find a dodo. Yeah, maybe that's our answer right there. Okay. Okay, little dodo. I apologize, little guy. I apologize. Just need a little bit of hide. Thank you very much for your sacrifice for the good of the squads. Now, let's just hasten our way back over here. Let's get ourselves... into here. I think that's it. We're good. We got ourselves a smithy already. All right. This has been good. This has been good. Day one is looking, if I may say so, and not jinx it too hard, a success. I think this is pretty success. I think this is a fantastic success. Let me get one last woe, just for good luck. Maybe even a second one. And I'm going to drop this over here. I could have put a window there, but I guess it's whatever, skis, baby. And now we can start getting into tools. I can get a crossbow. But most importantly, I can get myself a Maywing saddle. At least once I get the... once we get the metal, we can get this thing here. It's going to be awesome. Oh, and a lot of hide. And what else? Fiber. We need fiber as well. But once we get all of that, we get a Maywing saddle. And then tomorrow, if all goes according to plan, I'm thinking we head up to wherever it was that we spotted the old Maywings. I think they were over there. And we're going to tame one of those little duck-billed babies up. Yeah. But guys, if you ask me, this has been quite a successful start to the series. I'm excited to see what Genesis 2 holds for us. I look forward to see what adventures we end up on, and I hope you guys are too. If you did enjoy this video, please go ahead. Wait, let me do it. Go ahead and punch that thumbs up. Make it rain those thumbs up. But until next time, which will be tomorrow, keep on smiling. Have a fantastic day, and I'll catch you next time. Bye. Nope, that's not it. For now.